When it comes to reality car shows, Fast and Loud made quite a name for itself on the Discovery Channel. There are several shows out there that are all about vehicle repair and restoration. Some shows even give a ton of attention to the process of locating the vehicles to be restored. Fast and Loud took the approach as some other reality car shows do, flipping the vehicles for profit. It's an exciting concept and one that has found great success. Gas Monkey Garage in Dallas, Texas has made some incredible one-of-a-kind car builds on super short deadlines. But if it wasn't for Sue, yes, that crazy car upholstery lady on Fast and Loud, they wouldn't be where they are today. So where is Sue now? Does she still do interiors and upholstery? Does Richard and Sue still work together? No one has answered these questions until now. Watch till the end of the video for a chance to win $1,000 cash. And be sure to subscribe, click the bell, and like this video for more crusty content.
Why, Richard? Crazy gas monkey.
Hey, Sue.
What's up, monkey?
$1,000 for two measly seats?
Why you look at me like that, monkey? They're a cheap gas monkey.
To give you a little background on the show, Richard Rawlings and his crew at the Gas Monkey Garage in Dallas, Texas, purchase old classic cars and restore them into customized works of art. People at home are also given a unique opportunity to go with Richard on his journey throughout the United States to get his hands on some of these vehicles, which are often in absolutely horrible condition. As we see him plan the restoration, we are able to stick with him to the point where he ultimately flips them for a profit. As with many other shows, Fast and Loud was able to do so many amazing builds because there was a great crew working on them together. You have guys like Jason Aker, who brought his skills as a mechanic. Tony Kano was the go-to man for bodywork and amazing paint jobs. And of course, Aaron Kaufman is another skilled mechanic and loud personality that brings a bit of a wild card feel to the show. Now, these are the regular cast members that you'll be able to see on a regular basis. From time to time, though, there are specialists that come in to give the cars a little more of a special touch in some areas. That's how audiences got to know Yulan Haiso Martin. Viewers knew her by her shorter nickname, Sue. She was a regular on the show for a number of seasons and specialized in ultra-high-end upholstery. Whether it was a classic car or a newer muscle car, when Sue got her hands on it, people knew it was going to be something special. She also had a wild temper that made the interactions with the crew on the show even more entertaining. Anyone that has seen Sue at work knows that she has an incredible work ethic. This comes from her upbringing in Taiwan, where she was born into a family of farmers. During these times, she learned the value of working incredibly hard. There was also another trade that she picked up after seeking other work. She learned how to do upholstery. It was a skill that stuck with her for the rest of her life. Eventually, she got married and had children. Soon after, in 1984, she moved with her family to the United States, where they settled into new jobs, integrated into society, and started a wonderful new life. But in 1990, she had the opportunity to get started in the upholstery business. Her first project was to work on her husband's 1968 Gran Torino. She and a friend actually upholstered it in her garage, and it came out incredibly well. She knew from that point on that it was an industry that she wanted to dedicate herself to. Shortly after completing this project, she started working various positions until something fell into her lap that she knew was for her. She had the opportunity to purchase an existing upholstery company that was going bankrupt in Dallas, Texas. After spending $4,500 and moving into a 1,000 square foot garage, ASM Auto Upholstery was born.
I'm Sue, I'm the owner of ASM Auto Upholstery. Come on in! I own this 23 years. This is my second home. I like it. I spend a lot of time here. I spend 12 to 14 hours a day here. This is my daughter, Karen. She worked here 8 years. I try to train her to do business so I can retire someday.
Sue was an absolutely crazy hard worker, putting every ounce of energy into her work. There were even some occasions where she would work 24 hours a day for 3 or 4 days in a row, sleeping only a couple of hours here and there, all to make sure she made the deadlines. This tenacious spirit and work ethic was practiced for years and years in order to gain a reputation of the best of the best. The work paid off after a while, and she was able to move from her 1,000 square foot garage into a 2,000 square foot building across the street. It was when she moved into the new building, she was discovered by Richard Rawlings, who had a shop right down the street. Word had gotten around not only about the high quality work that Sue produced, but her bubbly and unique personality. It didn't take long for Richard to send her some work to get a first-hand look at her skills. Their business relationship was absolutely amazing, and once the show started filming as Gas Monkey Garage, she would pop in for a few jobs. She was an immediate hit with viewers. Just think, if Gas Monkey Garage had been located just about anywhere else, we may never have met Sue. What a tragedy that would have been. As the show continued, Sue started making more and more regular appearances. For some episodes, there would even be times where the camera crew would go down and shoot parts of the show from in her shop. It was not only a great opportunity for the show to have a great personality, but it did also wonders for Sue's business, as she was able to showcase exactly what quality of work she brings to the table for any of her clients. She always seemed to have tension with Richard and his crew, where viewers couldn't tell if it was acting or if she was really that angry. She even hated the name Gas Monkey, so she would call them Ass Monkey.
Gas Monkey, he stinks, he more like it. Ass Monkey.
Things were going well though, and viewers were really digging her presence on the show. But then, after a few seasons, she seemed to just disappear. There were no explanations as to why or what happened. They didn't even feature anything on the show that would have at least phased her out. She simply vanished. Now, for most shows, this wouldn't be such a big deal, as people have been known to come and go on a regular basis. But when it comes to Fast and Loud, the exits are a bit more dramatic. Taylor Sims died. Jordan Butler was fired for being insubordinate. Tom Smith was fired because he was constantly late and possibly drunk as well. Casey and Dustin left to run their own shops. And Keenan because he wanted to go to work with Casey and Dustin. These were all official reasons given for the departures from the show. With so many reasons why people had left, it made us wonder exactly what was going on with Sue's sudden disappearance, especially because there was absolutely no indication in any of the episodes that there was tension between Sue and Richard. Various car show forums and online threads blew up with various rumors as to what could have happened to Sue. The biggest theory going around is that there was some sort of business fallout, or that their relationship had just run its course. Users claim that Richard only ever used Sue for low-end rush jobs, which could have caused Sue to become bored or tired of not being able to showcase her true talents. Redditors also pointed out that Sue actually showed up on a few episodes of Misfit Garage, bringing about speculation that she could have been looking for a different show to work with. She even had them work on her custom 56 Ford truck. Finally, some Redditors simply claimed that her work was not all that it was cracked up to be, leading to a possible theory that Richard was actually the one not wanting to continue their business relationship. It's important to remember though, all of these are simply rumors and speculation. There have never been any official explanations as to why Sue wasn't in the picture anymore. While no one can say for sure what really went on with Sue in Fast and Loud, what can be said for sure is that Sue is doing just fine. That brings us back to that new building that she moved into from the 1,000 square foot garage. At the time, she doubled in size. Today, she owns that entire complex, all 8,800 square feet of it, and that's where her company ASM is located today. She is known far and wide for delivering the best quality work at a very affordable price. She not only works on car interiors, but Sue also does upholstery in airplanes and boats as well. There's literally nothing Sue can't do. As Gas Monkey Garage has turned into more of a car showroom with only a few cars being restored compared to several being worked on at a time during the filming of the show, it is most likely that they don't work together as much, if at all. The last official time we've seen the two together is in a post on Sue's Instagram for Richard's birthday in 2020. With all her popularity and fame from appearing on Fast and Loud and Misfit Garage, ASM is very busy and gets sent restoration shipments to them from all across the country. It is a true testament of the strength, resilience, and passion of a lady born from a family of farmers in Taiwan. If ever there was a perfect example of what the American dream is, Yulan Haiso Martin is a prime example. Thank you so much for watching until the end of the video. has promised to enter the $1,000 cash giveaway. Make sure you're subscribed to this channel, Tuna No Crust. Hit the notification bell, leave a like and comment down below, No Crust Nation, with your Cash App or Venmo. And that's it. We're also giving our viewers 10% off any Krusty merch using code TUNA. We'll see you next time.